Welcome to this new video where we will solve the surrounded regions problem. We have a board made of water cells and land cells. Cells with X represent water and cells with O represent land. We define the concept of region. A region is a collection of connected land cells, where connected means that they're horizontally or vertically adjacent. For example, here we have four regions. In this problem, we want to capture regions, but not any region. We want to capture only regions that are four-directionally surrounded by water. In other words, that don't have a cell that is on the border. Capturing a region means transforming it to water. So this is the problem we want to solve. Given a matrix of size n by m containing x and o, capture all regions that are four-directionally surrounded by x. A region is captured by flipping all O's into X's in that surrounded region. For example, if we have this board, we have four regions. But these two are not surrounded by water, they have cells that are on the border. So we capture these ones by turning them into water. The concept of region is similar to the concept of island in a previous problem we've seen on this channel. The number of islands problem. We had a matrix of water and land cells, and we wanted to count the number of islands. What we did to solve that problem was to traverse the matrix, and as soon as we found an unvisited land cell, it means that we found a new island. We increment the number of islands. We also set all cells of that island as visited by using the flat fill algorithm to avoid counting the same island twice. The flat fill algorithm can be implemented with BFS. We start from a land cell and we keep expanding by enqueuing adjacent land cells. To solve this problem, I thought of using the same process to identify regions. But here we have two types of regions, surrounded ones and non-surrounded ones. We want to capture surrounded ones only. This is why we cannot capture an island as soon as we found a land cell, because we don't know if it's surrounded or not. So I got the idea to use a surrounded map, a hash map where the key is the number of the region, and the value is if yes or no it's surrounded. When traversing a new region, we assume that it's surrounded, then while applying flat fill, if one of the cells of that island is on the border, then that island is not surrounded in reality. We set its value in the map to false. After doing this for all islands, we traverse them again, but now we know if an island is surrounded or not, so we transform surrounded regions to water, and we set not surrounded regions to land again. And we solve the problem. In brief, we started by identifying islands, if they're surrounded or not, then we captured surrounded ones and set back to land remaining ones. That's it. I wrote the solution in LeetCode, I submitted, I was confident, but surprise, time limit exceeded. The solution was not fast enough for some test cases. This is where you shouldn't panic or something, you just need to start thinking of a more efficient solution. Let's think about the problem in another way. We have two kinds of regions, surrounded ones and non-surrounded ones. To solve the problem, we can either search for surrounded ones and capture them, which is what we did in the first solution, or search for non-surrounded ones and capture remaining ones. At a first glance, there is no big difference. However, the difference is that surrounded regions can be anywhere in the middle of the board, we must traverse the whole board. While for non-surrounded ones, we know that they have a cell in the border, so we focus on regions that start from the borders only, which means that in the average case, we have less cells to traverse, hence less required time. For a small board, no big difference, but for this bigger board, look at the difference between the total surface of surrounded regions and non-surrounded ones. From this observation, the new solution would be to traverse borders only, and each time we find an unvisited land, we use flood fill to mark all the cells with a special character that says that they should not be captured. After doing so, we reset marked cells to land and transform all remaining ones to water, because they're either water or a part of a surrounded region. Let's implement this solution. Let's start by making a flood fill function that, starting from a land cell ij, traverses the whole island it belongs to by using BFS while marking cells with a special character, to later know that we shouldn't capture them. It's BFS, so we start by creating a queue where we put our initial cell ij. We also mark it in the board with this special character that should be different from X and O. Now while the queue is not empty, we extract the next cell ij. To traverse its adjacent cells, we traverse the cells in 4 directions, i+1j, i-1j, ij+1, and ij-1. To know that the cell belongs to the island and we should go to it, it must be inside the board and not visited yet. So we check if adj I is between 0 inclusive and n exclusive, the number of rows, and adj j is between 0 inclusive and m exclusive, the number of columns. And that it's an unvisited land cell, it should have the character O. If conditions are respected, then we should visit this cell, we add it to the queue, and we mark it with a special character in the board. It keeps looping like this until we mark the whole non-surrounded island. Now in the main solution function, we need to traverse borders. Border cells are cells ij whose I is either 0 or n-1, or j is either 0 or m-1. Let's start with cells where I is either 0 or n-1. For each column j, we're interested by the cells 0j and n-1j. For each one of them, if it's an unvisited land, we'll launch flood fill from there to mark the island. Now we traverse first and last row, we need to traverse what remains from first and last column. In the first column, j is 0, and in the last column, j is m-1. We traverse rows, and for each row I, we work with two cells, the one whose column is 0 and the one whose column is m-1. For each one of them, if it's an unvisited land, we'll launch flood fill from there to mark the island. Now all border islands are marked, we traverse all cells to set marked islands to land and remaining ones to water. For each cell ij, if it's marked, we set it to land, else if it's land, we set it to water. And we're done, we have nothing to return because the modification happens in place. This time, even if both solutions have the same time complexity, O of n times m, this one got accepted and didn't yield a time limit exception. It means that time complexity isn't everything, and sometimes we need to dig deeper. We've reached the end of this lecture, I hope that you understood the second approach to solve this problem. As usual, if you want to support the channel, like and subscribe, and check our courses in description. See you in the next one.